like whole half an hour and you are still Muslim? So, I see, I know that Muslims see Jesus as only prophet of God, but when I look at the Christian scripture, I don't see Christian scripture gives me any place that Jesus is only a prophet. Christian scripture teaches that Jesus is the Messiah. Christian scripture teaches Jesus is a prophet. Christian scripture teaches Jesus is the truly God-man. Christian scripture teaches Jesus is Son of God as well. So there are lots of titles. And also it is the same scripture teaches Jesus is the Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. He is the Lord of Lords, Kings of Kings. So why? I'll give you the reference on the Son of God, because that was your question. Before that, can you just tell me what is your understanding on the Son of God? What is, like, let's say, sake of the argument, Jesus, Son of God, what is your problem with that?
Well, I just think that was probably used metaphorically. Because if you look at the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 3, verse number 38, it talks about Adam, and it says, Adam, the Son of God. So it could just be used in a metaphorical way, rather than literally. And even if John...
Can you come a little slow?
But should I put on the microphone? Is it a bit quiet?
No, it will catch from you.
Okay. Yeah, so even John Hick, he said that the Greeks, they used it as a metaphor, and like an honorific title, because he could perform miracles. So I would say that it's just metaphorical.
So your understanding that Jesus is the Son of God is a metaphorical title, and your reference for that is Luke chapter 3 verse 21.
No, 38.
Sorry, 38, where Adam is also identified as the son of, Adam, and then Son of God, where like generation of Jesus goes. That doesn't answer my question. What is the Islamic understanding of Jesus, the Son of God? Is it just a metaphorical?
Yeah.
So does Islam believe Jesus is the Son of God?
No, they believe that he was a messenger.
Okay, so what is it in Islam that reason that Jesus cannot be the Son of God? What is your Quranic objection?
I think Surah Kahf, chapter number 18, it says they thought that he was... I don't know from the Quran, but...
Chapter 18?
Yeah, they said that they think that Jesus... was the Son of God.
Reference? Is that the verse? I read it from verse 1 to 4. All praise due to Allah, who has sent down his servant Muhammad the book and has not made therein any deviance. He has made it straight and to warn of several punishment from him, and to give good tidings to the believers who do righteous deeds, and they will not have a good reward, in which they will remain forever, and warn to those who say Allah has taken a son. So do you believe this verse is towards the Christians? Yes. Okay, you need to come close if you want to cut. So do Christians believe Allah has taken a son?
No.
Who is this verse for?
It's for the Christians.
So do you believe this verse is for Christians? You said yes.
Yeah.
So according to this verse, Christians believe Allah has taken a son.
Yeah.
I am Christian. I don't believe Allah has taken a son.
As in the Son of God.
I don't believe Allah has taken a son. What is the festival means Allah has taken a son? There was a time and place, God, I'll call it God because I don't believe Allah is my God.
Yeah.
God, there was a time and place, God was by himself, and then he suddenly said, oops, let me get a son, and then he take a son. Is that what this verse is saying?
No, I think it's referring to, you know, where does it say that Jesus is the Son of God in the Bible? Say, for example, is it John 3:16 that says...
God so loved the world that he That's not the verse you are looking for.
But just, you know how Christians say that Jesus is the Son of God?
Christians say Jesus is Son of God, but Christians never said God has taken a son. We never said that. So, the moment you establish for me what Islamic scripture teaches about Christians believe on the Son of God, I will unpack what we believe and why Quran messed up. In here, it tells us Allah taking a son. I am Christian. My scripture does not teach. There was a time and place. Allah was fatherless. And then suddenly he adopted a son. We don't believe that. Jesus is the eternal Son of God. He was existed from eternity. Will be exist to eternity. He is Godhead. Christians believe one God in three persons. Father, Son, and Spirit. There was no time and place. Father wasn't exist. There was no time and place. Son wasn't exist. There was no time and place. Spirit wasn't exist. Therefore, this verse cannot be speaking to us because we never said there was a time and place God took Jesus as son. We never said that. So, since this verse is not to me, can you show me other verses? What Quran understand from the Son of God?
I don't have any more. That's the only one that I knew.
Okay, so...
But in the Bible, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God?
So, first shall we establish that Quran doesn't know anything about what Christians believe on the Son of God. Is that correct, according to you?
No, I'm saying that I myself don't have any other evidence. That's the only one that I know myself.
Okay.
But I know
so
in the Quran
this is clearly I already told you this is not for Christians.
Okay.
So since your eternal word of God, Allah doesn't understand what
I
believe.
I do myself.
Okay. You do your homework and then bring me verses and then we look at that. For now I'll just go how much you know. Okay? According to the reference you give me, so far Allah doesn't even understand what Christians believe when it comes to the basic doctrine of Christians. That says a lot of about intelligence of Allah. You will check that out. So,
since Allah doesn't know that,
can you just tell me, what do you believe me as a Christian, I believe about Son of God, I understand about the Son of God?
Okay, correct me if I'm wrong, but don't you believe that, you believe in the Trinity?
And what is the Trinity? Who is the Trinity?
The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Okay.
And they're all equal. And they're all the same. They all act the same. They all think the same. Am I correct in that?
No.
So they're separate. They're not. So are they separate or not separate?
I'll give you one more time to put your thoughts together, and then I'll explain.
No, I don't know. I'm asking.
Okay. First of all, as you stated that Christians believe in Trinity, Father, Son, and Spirit. Once again, you went against your Quran. Because Quran doesn't understand what I believe when it comes to Trinity. So I have to congratulate you for knowing much more than Allah. So, first of all, Trinity is believing in one God. There is only one God. Okay? His personal name is Yahweh, which Quran again ignores. God is in three persons. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit. They are persons, not beings. Okay? One essence, three persons. They are distinct from one another, yet they work together. There is a community with them. Which confirms that Quran doesn't even understand that. So Father is not the Son, Son is not the Father. Father doesn't force his opinions to Son. Son doesn't force his opinions to Spirit. So they work together. And they are one being in essence. So it is that we say Christian scripture teaches Father is truly God, truly God, Son is truly God, Spirit is truly God, yet it is one God. So with that background information, so can you now tell me what do you believe Christians believe on the Son of God?
Okay, just to ask you a quick question. Do you also believe that all of them have equal knowledge? as in they all know, they all have an equal amount of knowledge about everything.
Do I believe three persons of Trinity have the equal knowledge? Christian scripture teaches second person of the Trinity, the Son, incarnated. He became a servant, so he limited himself. He is truly God-man. Therefore, his knowledge is different since he took up human form. He took up something on him. Because of that, scripture tells us, eternal Son of God didn't know the hour. Okay? So, yet, as the Son of God, as the eternal Son of God, he knew the hour before the incarnation. With the incarnation, he became limited because he took up human flesh. He walked and lived. He said, I am. He was hungry, yet he said, I am the bread of life. He was thirsty, he said, I am the living water. So he is truly God, truly man. Are you going to answer my question? What do you understand Christians believe on the Son of God? Since we know Quran doesn't understand, but what do you understand?
Now I'm asking you the question, what you believe, why is Jesus not, why is he not just a prophet? Why is he the Son of God? But you're asking me about my understanding, but I'm asking why he's the...
I'm asking what you understand, because so far, all the things you understand goes against Quran and goes against Islamic teachings. Christians believe Jesus is the Son of God because God himself calls Jesus, you are my son, I love you, I am well pleased with you. Jesus calls God the Father, you are my father. Disciples calls Jesus, you are the Son of God. That is the very reason Jesus died on the cross, because people believed he claimed to be the Son of God. That is the very reason people wanted to stone him, because he claimed to be the Son of God, where he claimed to be equal to the God himself. I'm gonna give you the verse, but I want you to tell me, as a Muslim, what do you believe Christians believe in this with the Son of God?
What's that got to do?
I'm just going to give you the verse.
I think it's Matthew 10:34.
No.
Or is it John 10:34?
No, sir. John chapter 5. So, because Jesus was doing these things on the Sabbath, okay? Sabbath is the time where Jews don't do any work, and Jesus was a Jew. The Jews persecuted him. Jesus said to them, my father, remember, my father, not Allah, not God, my father, is always at his work to this very day, and I am working. For this reason, the Jews try all the harder to kill him. Not only because he was breaking the Sabbath, but he was even calling God his own father, making himself equal with God. So I believe Jesus is the Son of God because Christian scripture teaches Jesus is the Son of God.
And so religious people
believe Jesus was the Son of God as well. Therefore, they wanted to stone him because he was blaspheming. And it looks like you are coming to Speakers Corner with your shopping list, because I answered your questions and now you are asking me second question.
Let
me just clarify. I am not Marks and Spencer here, you come for shopping, okay? So I answered your questions and now you need to answer my questions. Tell me, what do you understand Christians believe with the Son of God?
Okay, so can I just reply to what you said? So you said that Jesus basically called himself the Son of God. But I think, I'm not sure if it's Matthew or John. Let's just say it was John. So John chapter 10, verse number 34. He calls himself the Son of God. And I think the Pharisees, they tried to persecute him for saying so. But then he refers to the book of Psalms, chapter number 82, verse number 6.
Wrong reference.
No, it's, I think, was it Matthew 10, 34?
Matthew 10:34.
Yeah.
That's wrong reference. I'm going to give you the right reference a little bit later, but first let me read the wrong reference. Do not suppose that I come to bring peace to the earth. I did not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to turn, quotation from Micah 7, a man against his father, a daughter against his her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemy will be members of his own house. Anyone who loves his father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. So your reference was wrong. Your next reference is what?
I think it was John.
John chapter 10 verse 33.
34.
Jesus answered, Is it not written in the law? I have said that you are gods. I have called them gods to whom the word come, and the scripture cannot be broken. So that's not the reference you are looking for either. Yeah. This is in the context where Jesus claimed to be equal to the God in essence and in nature. And Jesus gives the quotation from Psalm 82, and Psalm 82, and then says, don't you know that word who come to judge you? Watch out, Pharisees. So that doesn't help your case either.
No,
so
explain that.
Just a moment. Since you gave me the wrong references, okay? After I help you out. So can you? This doesn't even talk about Jesus to be the Son of God. Okay, this talk about Jesus to be God. I am, because your reference comes from I and my Father one. I and my Father are one on the side.
Can I explain? So over here, Jesus was claiming to be the Son of God.
Not in here.
Yeah, I think he does over here.
Where? Verses, you claim to be God, and then quotation comes from 82.
Yeah, he says, like, my Father has given them to me, is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand.
Yeah.
So here, and he says, and the Father and I are one. Which
so Christian, he's not saying I am Son of God. He's saying I am God.
Yeah, he's talking about my Father.
No. That's not in that case. Don't butcher my scripture. I'll let you to finish, but I'm not going to allow you to butcher my scripture. Okay? I already give you the quotation. There was a quotation I already give you. Jesus made a claim that he is the Son of God. And the next quotation is John 19. So John 10 is the claim Jesus directly makes that he is God.
Okay. So here he's talking about his Father and how my Father and I are one.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's implying that he is the Son of God and there's the Father and they're one as a Trinity, as you said.
No. But then,
is that not referring to the Trinity?
No. Your interpretation is wrong.
Okay, what's that talking about?
I'll interpret John chapter 10, but I'm not going to allow you to get away with not answering my question, okay? So, I'll read the John chapter 10 from verse 25, and then I'm going to unpack that for you. And then hopefully that will enlighten some stuff. Jesus answered, I did tell you, but you do not believe. The miracles I do in my Father's name speak for me, but I do not believe. But you do not believe because you are not my sheep. My sheep listen to my voice. My sheep listen to my voice. Jesus is saying, I am God, because Psalm 95, Psalm 23, we know sheep of God is us. So God has the sheep, not Jesus. God has the sheep. Jesus in this verse says, I am that God who is the shepherd, who has those sheep. And they listen my voice. His voice is that strong. People listen his voice. His voice is that powerful. People obey that voice. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them. They follow me. He is that powerful. He knows who are his sheep. He is that powerful. His sheep can recognize him. I give them eternal life. Jesus is that powerful to give eternal life, yet we know It is only God who can give eternal life. Jesus is already making a claim. He's that God who gives eternal life. And they shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hands. Which is the language in Old Testament used for God of Old Testament. Jesus is saying, I am that God. I am that God. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand. I and my Father are one. Jesus simply said, I am God. At this moment, you should be bowing down and worshiping not Jesus Christ, because the passage you brought it to me already proves Islam is false religion, because Allah is Father to no one. The passage you brought to me already proves Jesus gives life, eternal life, not any eternal life, very, very quality eternal life, which disproves Islam, because it is only Allah who gives eternal life. Let me continue. I and the Father are one. We are one. Again, the Jews picked up the stone to stone him. Why would Jews ever do that? Because, but Jesus said to them, I have shown you many great miracles from the Father. For which of those you stone me? We are not stoning you for any of those, replied Jews. They are not stoning him because of the miracles, but because you, a mere man, claim to be God. God gives eternal life, Jesus gives eternal life. God has sheep, Jesus has sheep. Everyone can recognize the voice of God. All the sheep, Jesus says, my sheep, they know my voice. They know me, I'll give them eternal life. Therefore, those Jewish people thought Jesus is claiming to be God in this verse, okay? And then it goes on.
Okay, so can I just rebuttal?
Sure, respond to that one.
Yes, so he's basically talking about how he's the Son of God or he's God. Yeah.
They're different things.
Okay. And after what? So the Pharisees say, why would you do something like that? And they try to stone him. And then he says, he's basically saying that it's metaphorical. And if you go to some...
He's not saying that.
He is, because he's...
No, you didn't let me to come to that part.
Yeah.
And I'm so sorry to see that you just butcher my scripture again. Even 5 minutes ago, I told you do not butcher my scripture. They wanted to stone him for blaspheming, because you are a mere man and you are claiming to be God. Okay? So I made my point on first part of the John chapter 10. If you make your point.
Okay, so they're calling him, they're accusing him of committing blasphemy because he claimed to be God.
Yes, but just confirming, not the Son of God as you said previously, God, yeah?
Yeah, so then he refers to the book of Psalms, chapter number 82, verse number 6. So can you go to it?
By the way, we don't say Book of Psalms, we say Psalms 84, 82.
Oh, okay.
Just for language thing.
Oh, okay.
Psalm 82, verse
6.
Shall I read it? I said, you are gods. You are all sons of the Most High. But you will die like a mere man. You will fall like every other ruler.
So this implies that Jesus was referring to that verse, and he was only talking about it in a metaphorical sense. So you know how the Jews, they were called kings and gods. He's basically saying that when I'm calling myself God and I say I give eternal life, I'm basically referring to what the Jews were called in Psalm.
Let me respond to that. That passage doesn't even give us any right to think they are quoting this as a metaphorical. That's fine. I'll pick it up. That's fine. Let me read the first and then respond to you. So we finished in verse 33, where Jewish people want to kill Jesus because he was blaspheming. Okay? He made a claim that he's God. 34. Jesus answered them, "Is it not written in the law, 'I have said you are gods'? If he called them gods, to whom the word of God come, and the scripture cannot be broken, what about the one whom the Father set apart as his very own and set into the world? Why then do you accuse me of blasphemy because I said I am God's son? Do not believe me unless I do what my Father does. But if I do it, even though you do not believe me, believe the miracles that you may know and understand the Father is in me and I am in the Father." Again, they tried to seize him, but he escaped from grasp. So that was what the passage was saying. Yes, quotation comes from Psalm 82. And Psalm 82, I am sure you already knew what psalm it was about. It is about the judgment psalm. It's judgment psalm. Psalm 82, God proceeds in the great assembly. He gives judgment among the gods. Jewish people who know their scripture very well, they, when Jesus said, because in the Psalms it says this, Jewish people knew Jesus is saying in that psalm where it states, before you guys, let me read it. "How long will you defend the unjust and show partially to the wicked? Defend the cause of the weak and the fatherless. Maintain the rights of the poor and opposed. Rescue the weak and needy. Deliver them from the hand of the wicked. They know nothing. They understand nothing. They walk about in darkness. All the foundation of the earth are shaken. I said, you are gods. You are all sons of the Most High, but you will die like a mere man. You will fall like every other ruler." The moment Jesus gives the quotation from Psalm 82, all Jewish people understand that is the judgment of God incarnated, stands in front of us. And that judgment of God, word of God, is going to judge us. Still they want to kill him, man. Still they want to kill him. So, since John chapter 8 didn't help you out, and if John chapter 8 was a metaphorical, as you said, can you just tell me how come Jewish people still wanted to kill Jesus if that claim was a metaphorical that he claimed to be God?
Yeah, that's Jesus' point. He's saying, why are you trying to kill me for claiming that I'm God when your own people were called gods?
That's not the whole point. If that was the whole point, Jewish people wouldn't want to kill him.
Yeah,
whole
that's point, the point of that he's trying to make.
No. Whole point of it is Jesus is saying, "I am that world in Psalm 82, and I am here, and I am gonna come and judge the world, man. Watch out, Jewish people. You know that scripture. You know what? That passage is also today speaks to Muslims. Muslim claims they have the word of God. Yet Jesus says, you believe you have the word of God, but I am the one who is gonna come and judge you, man. Watch out. I know it doesn't say in the Quran. Quran messed up. You just wait, sir. Quran just messed up. So, John chapter 10 clearly not only talks about the Jewish, also condemns the Muslims today who denies Jesus' sonship, who denies the Jesus' essence, who says, I'll give them eternal life, my sheep knows me, all those things, man, you've got to watch out. So, since I respond to your question, can you just respond to my question? What is the Quranic interpretation of the Son of God, and what is your interpretation of the Son of God? So you don't know? Okay. So I'll help you on that, okay? So, in the Quran, Jesus was born from Virgin Mary, correct? And in Surah 19, we see how that takes place. Ruh of Allah becomes a perfect man. Okay? Ruh of Allah, which is supposed to be the part of Allah, becomes a perfect man, appears to Mary, and then tells Mary she's gonna have a baby. And then we come to Surah 66. And then we see how Jesus becomes baby. And Mary, the daughter of Imran, who guarded her farsh, I'm sure you know Arabic and you know what is that word means. So we blew into her garment through our angel. So she believed in the words of the Lord and his scripture and was the devotedly obedient. According to this passage, as the Ruh of Allah revealed to Mary in John chapter 19, come to in a perfect shape of man. Mary wasn't even able to recognize if he's perfect man or if he's something else. Mary thinks he's perfect man, okay, six packs, all those good height, all those perfect man shapes.
Well, you said that that's and, the Son of God. How does that make
and,
the Son of God?
And that Ruh of Allah blew into Mary's vagina to make her pregnant. Okay? So, according to this verse, Jesus is the Son of the Ruh of Allah. No? So who made Mary pregnant? Who made Mary pregnant?
She didn't have, Isa didn't have a father.
Isa didn't have father. In chapter 19, the Ruh of Allah reveals to Mary in a perfect man. Chapter 66, Ruh of Allah blow into Mary's private part. It says, we blow into her private part. I'm asking the simple question. Who is son is Jesus according to Quran? Who blow into the Mary's private part to make Mary pregnant?
Yeah, it's a metaphorical use of it. Because even if you look
how come,
the
how come, just a moment, how come this is metaphorical use? Metaphorical?
Because even in the Quran it says that God never took a son.
I'm not talking about, you already showed me that verse. I want you to deal with this verse, okay? In chapter 19, Ruh of Allah, part of Allah, becomes a perfect man, Ruh of Allah can do something Allah cannot do. And that Ruh of Allah, in Surah 66, blow into Mary's vagina and Mary becomes a pregnant. So whose son is Jesus?
It's no one's, because even if you look at the Quran, it also says
if
that
Jesus is the son of no one, says, what is that
even
called?
It says that we breathe our spirit into Adam. It doesn't mean that Adam is the son of God. Even if you look at the Bible,
I'm not talking about they blow. So I know it, they blow, they breathed into Adam and then Adam had a life. Okay? But in here, Ruh of Allah is Ruh of Allah who revealed himself to Mary in chapter 19 blows into Mary's private part. By that time, in Mary's tummy, there is no baby. From that baby appears. Okay? Surah 66, 12. Do you have Arabic? Have you got Arabic? You don't even have your Quran with you?
Sorry, where does it say?
Muslims come to speakers' corner, they don't even bring their Quran.
I've got it. Yeah, like I said before, it even says in the Quran that we breathe into Adam, but that doesn't mean that Adam is the son of God.
I'm not asking that. I know Islamic scripture and Christian scripture agree. Adam is the first man God created and then give life as a human being. I am asking in here, who is, according to this verse, made Mary pregnant?
It was God, but it does not mean that he directly...
Where is it God?
It doesn't mean that he directly and literally breathed his spirit into him. And I just gave you another example.
No. I don't want examples. I want you to just explain this to me.
Yeah, I know.
So what Allah meant when he said, Ruh of Allah blow into the Mary's private part. So what did Allah meant?
Yeah, what I just said before, that is metaphorical. It doesn't mean that God literally breathed his spirit into it. And I just gave you another example.
Okay, you need to give me reasons why you don't believe that's not metaphorical.
Pardon?
Hi. Is it possible to avoid one more week here? Because I had a lot of problems.
Shame on you.
I've got the book if you need it back. But I need
Have
one
you read
more
it?
I've not read all of it. It's a big book.
Okay, this
let
is...
Let me get them with some... Can I give you the book here? And you tell me what parts like, I should read.
No, you need to read all of it.
I need to read all of it. Anyway.
It's very quick reading anyway.
Yeah. So let me read all
next
of it.
Next week.
Let me read all of it, okay?
Next week.
And inshallah, we'll go back to it, inshallah.
Okay. Look, what's your name? He's our witnesses.
He's a witness.
So he's got my book for 3 weeks now. He's gonna bring it next week. If you don't turn up with my book, which is 60, I think it's over £60 easily, okay? That my feelings won't be very good towards you.
Yeah.
Sir, can you get down please?
Allahu Akbar, takbir.
Thank you.
I don't know. I've never signed up for this.
That's fine. See you next week.
Okay, so what I'm trying to say is, even though it says we blew into her garment, it doesn't literally mean that God breathed a part of him into the private part.
So, it's not God, it is the Ruh of Allah. So, can you just tell me, while Allah said, we blow into her private part, what actually Allah meant? So how did Mary having a baby in her tummy?
Yeah, it was the soul of...
How did that soul happen?
The soul of Jesus was put into the body of Mary.
How?
What do you mean how?
How? So today, if I want to have a baby, I will need a husband and then I will have to have sex with him and then I will make a baby. Okay? So Mary was a virgin according to Islamic tradition. She didn't have a husband. How did baby Jesus end up in her tummy that she walked around for pregnant for 9 months?
I just told you.
No, you didn't tell me.
I told you he breathed a spirit. He breathed Prophet Isa's spirit into Mary.
But you just told me that was a metaphor. Now you are just telling me, yes, they blew their spirit into her.
But it doesn't necessarily...
Which you just said metaphor.
Okay. It's life.
Okay, so you agreed...
But we...
So you agreed that, like, in the normal sense, a part of the husband and a part of the wife falls. Do you agree with that?
I agree. In 2018, technology is growing.
No,
they don't even have like, they don't even need men now. So, in natural, godly way, is man and woman has a sex and then baby turns up to be baby.
Yeah.
For baby to turn up, woman of approximately 9 months walk around as a pregnant woman. So, I am asking simple question. If Surah 66, just a moment.
Are you
not Muslim?
Is the brother Muslim?
Yes, he's Muslim.
Yeah. Are you sure? Yeah, but I was watching you. She was talking and you were looking at this. I mean, are you interested? Or are you just making an act here, to be honest with you? Because if you're making an act, it's not... It can't be. Because if you're making a commentaire, if you're making a problem, it should be very, very genuine.
So are you Muslim or not, sir?
Yeah.
He is Muslim. So...
Yes, as
Mary was walking around the pregnant, I am asking simple question. How that soul end up in Mary's tummy?
Okay, can I explain without interruption? So So you agree that in the normal sense, yeah, just generally, that first it's like a man's liquid and a woman's liquid. A part of him and a part of the woman. Yeah, it's part of him and it goes into like the private part and so on. But here, it wasn't a part of Allah, a part of God. It was just a soul. It was Jesus' soul which he created. But it doesn't mean that it was a part of God which he took off him and then put into Mary. It was just Jesus' soul which he created. But he didn't have a father. Do you understand?
I hear what you are saying, and as you will confirm, what you are saying doesn't make sense. Here's the thing, here's the thing. I'm not gonna teach you the basic of biology, because I think you are too big, too old for that. I'm just gonna read this simply verse for you, and I want you to unpack the verse for me. And Mary, the daughter of Imran, who guarded her Farj, so we blew into through our angel. So she believed in the words of her Lord and his companion, his scriptures, so was of the devotedly obedient. So Spirit is creating Jesus in this verse. If you are telling me actually that's not what Allah meant, Allah has a communication problem, but one of the things I can do is, why don't you do homework and then come back to me after you explain? No, your explanation doesn't make sense to me.
Okay, what is my explanation?
Your explanation is, it wasn't any part of Allah, but it was the ruh of Allah who revealed himself in a perfect man, to Mary, and then they blow into the Mary. So what comes out from that? That's the breath. They put their breath into Farj of Mary, into her private part.
Is that literal when it says we blew? Because that would imply that God has a mouth.
If it wasn't, God, we know God has eyes, we know God has legs.
But we don't believe it.
No, Islam teaches that.
It doesn't.
Sir, let's not go to the basics. We know Islam teaches Allah has arms, Allah has sight, Allah has face, those kind of physical descriptions.
Yeah, it's metaphorical, but it doesn't have
it's not a metaphorical.
In the same way that we do.
If it was metaphorical, he wouldn't be sitting on the throne. That's a different topic. So, the verse clearly says, we blow into her. So, sounding from Allah end up in Mary's private part. I'll encourage you to do homework for that, and then we pick up from there.
I even gave you another example to make it easier to explain. I gave an example of Adam when it says that we blew our spirit into him.
Adam was already alive. Adam was already exist. Jesus is not exist. Okay. Jesus is not in the tummy yet.
So you agree that the body and the soul, they're separate. So the soul can be a separate individual thing. Would you agree with that?
Sir, make it simple. So Adam was formed, remember, all Friday afternoon, and Adam said, Allah finish me before it's too late. Allah give him breath and then Adam lived. Okay?
So
Adam got a life with his breath. But Jesus start being existed the moment breath of Ruh of or Allah entered in the Mary's private part. Do homework, look at the hadith, and then we discuss continue next week.
Okay, maybe I haven't explained it well enough.
Okay, practice your communication skill and then we talk next week. Next week? Okay. So, do you want to conclude for next week or we just continue next week?
Yeah, okay, next week.
Okay, question was simply how Jesus can be the Son of God. Jesus is Son of God because Christian scripture teaches that, but Islamic scripture misunderstand what Christian scripture teaches by telling us Ruh of Allah revealed in a perfect form of man and they blow into Mary's private part. So according to Islamic scripture, Allah has a physical, biological something to do with the word, with the Jesus to be Son of God. But on the side note, remember I already told you, Christians never believe God take a son. Can you please do a homework on that as well? And then we talk about it next week. Okay?